Just want to introduce the next speaker, Brian Smith, who's a local community unionist and socialist. So, listen to it as well. Thank you.
Thanks very much, folks. Thanks to the Radical Independence Conference for inviting us along. I know a lot of you in the room have tried to elect as a socialist candidate for Castlemilk many times and want to remember and be involved in that campaign. In my day job, I'm the Unison branch secretary in Glasgow, so I talk to trade unionists and to workers every day. So I judge things by what is going to be the benefit to all the working class people and what means that is going to give us after the 18th of September to actually do something different. Because I think there's two main reasons why working class people and young people are going to vote yes or have decided they're voting yes. And it's nothing, as Deborah says, to do with nationalism. It's to do with the idea that austerity is wrong, that the bosses are having a go at working class folk, and you don't want your children to grow up in the sort of society we've got at the minute. So it's a class vote against austerity, and that's why we need to be absolutely clear that it's not just about voting yes, it's about what happens after the 18th of September, and we need to think about that just now. No, leave it to the 19th of September. We need to think about that just now. And most of our remarks are going to be round about that issue, because that's where I come from on the discussion. The second reason I think working class people are voting yes or will consider voting yes is a democratic issue. People want more control of their lives. Who doesn't want more control of your lives? For those of you who have been involved in anti-cuts campaigns, many times here at the Glasgow Secretary we talk about empowerment. Good. People want control over their lives, and there's something about the referendum that gives people the idea that they have a bit more democracy in their lives. So I think people are attracted to that idea, because through history, working class people wanted more control of their lives, because you don't want the boss telling you what you're doing, whether it was wage doing the mines, or even at the minute of a zero-year contract, you want control of your lives. So there's an idea of democracy in there, which I think is attractive to folk, and if that discussion isn't taking place, the Yes campaign, or those who are arguing for the Yes campaign, are missing a trick, because there's something there which people would want to engage in. So it's about an alternative economy, and I think it's about democracy. Because who would want the current situation? The idea of the 99% huffing fight with the 1% all the time just to get the crumbs is not a world that I want to live in. I'm a socialist, I want to change the world. I don't want to change it to have a salt tire or a UB40 instead of a Union Jack. I'm not employed, if I was unemployed, I want to have a different type of society, and that is what we need to expose over the next period of time. We can't have 20% of kids living in poverty. We don't need an economic system that's based on profit, not in need. Zero contracts, unemployment, we don't even need to go through the list of things. Victoria spoke about the welfare state. I thought that was a very moving expose of the ATOS situation on a particular individual. But what this crew at Westminster are doing is trying to take away where forefathers and foremothers fought for, which was the creation of the post-war settlement. Through Thatcher unwound it a lot, but Tony Blair, Gordon Brown and David Cameron are doing a better job than she ever got a tough to say. So we need to say that loud and clear. And there's an intense anger in working class communities about that. There's an intense anger among trade unionists, among unemployed people, among disabled campaigners about what they are doing with your welfare state. And we should put that idea front and centre when we're arguing with people about how they should vote on the 18th of September. Because as I say, I judge things by not what my country is going to benefit. Because I don't want the Duke of Menteith or the Lord of Glenbeckie running Scotland. I want all the working class people running Scotland, because we are the majority. So I don't judge it by what's best for my country, I judge it by what's best for my class. And that's how we should judge how we vote on the 18th of September. The idea of Home Rule has been a strong, strong thing for working class people in Scotland for 200 years. Keir Hardie argued for Home Rule, the right Clydesiders argued for Home Rule, and Deborah's right. It wasn't because it was a tartan Clydeside that Scottish people made in the west of Scotland have a more progressive, social democratic, socialist outlook, whatever you want to put it. It's because that has particular historical time, which is still with us, that the idea of the working class being organised was a more of a proportion of that in the west of Scotland. So it was a red Clydeside, it wasn't a tartan Clydeside, and we should make that point loud and clear. The bosses are against, I guess, for it. that immediately tells you I'm probably the yes campaign. We should have a bit more thought out than that, just because David Cameron and all the rich toffs that run the City of London, the bankers are all against it. And you're automatically for it, although sometimes that's not a bad barometer to use in these things. But what the no campaign say? The no campaign are saying you'll get exactly the same if you vote no. That's very inspiring. Very inspiring. So I'll vote no to get mayor cuts and to get sent to Athos and to go over Joe and stop you being a zero contact. That's great. Let's have that. And I'll tell you about that. And it isn't stopping, I'm being humorous there. But I'll tell you the two comments from Labour politicians, one Scottish and one at a UK level, that exposes why people should consider voting yes. The idea that the leader of the so-called Workers' Party in Scotland, Joanne Lamott, says we should get rid of something for nothing culture is outrageous. It's saying deserving poor against undeserving poor, the employed against unemployed, the able-bodied against disabled. That was that was about. It's a scandal that she made that comment. A person called Rachel Reeves, who's the chief secretary to the Treasury, the shadow minister, said in a comment in Newsnight, she wants to be tougher in welfare than the Tories. I don't want to live in a UK where the Labour Party are tougher in welfare than the Tories. I want them to have a better welfare state. So the no campaign are offering absolutely nothing. And then they're trying to frighten folk in some of the comments I've already been made about that. And see anybody in the Labour Party, and the road through our sides there, see anybody in the Labour Party who's looking for somebody to blame, if there is a yes vote, if that's what they want to do, they should look themselves in the mirror. It's for allowing their party to become a capitalist, out and out neoliberal party that has meant all the working class folk are saying, I think I'm going to vote yes, because that historically, in the last 45 years, hasn't been the case. The polls didn't show that. It's because people are making a judgment about what's best for them as all the working class people, and they feel let down and rightly so by what Labour have done in the last 25 years. As a socialist, I would look at the SNP's programme and what they have got to offer in their white paper. At least it's a vision. It's a vision of a fair society. There's the idea of low many Tories if you don't vote for them, which is a democratic society. But as a socialist who's arguing for a yes vote, I'm a critical yes vote, because I think some of the things in the white paper are a bit contradictory. I don't see how you can have good public services, better jobs, high growth economy, high wage and a low taxation. I don't get it, because they're not taking any of the public ownership either. So I think there's a bit of a contradiction in there. And tying yourself to the monetary policies of the Bank of England is a mistake. But again, that's something that could change. But it'd be wrong not to say there's flaws within what's in the white paper. But overall, it's more progressive, clearly, than what's offered from the no side. That's an absolute fact. One of the big issues for me is about working class organisations. As a trade unionist, I spent my life trying to organise workers, going to conferences, trying to organise workers, going on the street, trying to organise workers or talking to folk in their workplaces. The failure of the UK trade union leadership to actually do anything meaningful against the Tories' cuts is one of the reasons why people are voting yes as well. Because if they had got involved in fighting the Tories, and had actually called some action to fight austerity, they would therefore have the ability to say you should vote no and you should stay with us. That again is a failure. Most of them tied up with the Labour Party. A few notable exceptions within some of the trade unions, and the PCS, and the deceased Bob Crow, who actually argued for the idea of generalised strike action against the Tories to resist some of the austerity stuff. Some of our trade union leaders have been terrible, including the leader of Unionist, who is an outrage in terms of how he deals with some of the UK stuff to do with the union. The other issue of working class organisations, who do you vote for? Who do you vote for? Because as far as I'm concerned, there's a crisis of political representation for working class people. And again, during the referendum campaign, people are engaged in politics, they're talking about politics, they're talking about, I'm going to vote yes, who do I vote for? I don't like them, I don't like her. But we should be talking about what's the right thing for working class people in relation to political representation. So it's an opportunity to have that discussion, to try and build some of the alternatives to that. And who knows what will happen after, I guess, after the 18th of September. But it's going to be raised now. It's got to be raised in the context of the referendum. No way until the yes votes here. You've got to talk about that just now and get involved in that now. And why? Because as far as I'm concerned, you'll no get rid of poverty. You'll no get rid of ATOS. You'll no have zero of contracts abolished unless you have some socialist measures which are introduced in the independent of Scotland. And you have to have a vehicle to do that, and it's going to be a left-wing socialist working class vehicle which takes that forward, which is why we need that discussion as well as arguing for the yes vote. We've got to see how we're going to organise ourselves to make sure the yes vote actually delivers for us. Because the IMF and the bankers and the City of London and the people around the European Union, they may say after a yes vote on the 18th of September, you've had your fun, you thought there was democracy here, but by the way, here's the rules. Here's the rules of capitalism. Here's what's going to happen now. See if we know that somebody can resist that, at least in some measure, we'll be doing ourselves a disservice, and we wouldn't be honest with ourselves unless we do that. Because we need public ownership, we need better benefits, we need our economy, which is about nationalising the banks, the oil companies, the energy companies, so that they work for us, not for the shareholders and the folk who rip us off every single day. And crucially, from my point of view, none of the two sides say much of this. I wouldn't expect no side to say anything about it, because they've been using them. You've got to get rid of the anti-trade union laws, you've got to allow working class people who are lucky enough to go and in a place unionised to actually use that collective power. And you've got to argue then for the anti-trade union laws to be lifted, because that has been a break, as well as some of the union leadership, that has been a break when we've been able to defend people in the last 4 or 5 years. So yes, vote, yes, but we've got to build for what happens now, before September, and crucially past September. And it's exactly the right time to talk about how we organise ourselves, the vision that we want to see for Scotland. Because I don't want to live in an independent capitalist Scotland, I want to live in a socialist Scotland, which is why I would say vote yes, but here's all the other things we need to get involved in as working class people.